Okay, so I need to turn the printer off and unlock the print head. So I'm gonna lift this up and then put it down. It'll move. And then when it does that, I'm gonna unplug it. Alright, so that's that part. Alright, so now that we have the print head free and movable, I'm gonna try to take you guys in here. Let me Okay, so if we're coming into the printer, we're gonna re try to remove these pinwheels right here, because this is what's scratching the design. So to do that, one, I'm gonna just see if they pop out, but I don't believe these. Okay, so we need to unscrew. First, we need to screw. So I'm unscrewing these top two screws. Which just unlocks that piece. And then I'm gonna unscrew this part right here. I kind of wonder how I could get to that. If there is a maybe safer way. Alright, now that I have that screw removed, this is kind of movable. So I'm gonna kind of move it out of the way so I can get to the screw behind it. It's gonna be hard to do the camera, so I'm gonna just pause it. Alright, so once you unscrew the screw, you just need to kind of lift this up and pull the roller out from the spring. Don't remember how I did it. I'm just gonna yank it. Fuck it. Let's yellow this shit. Now I gotta put this shit back together. Just gotta put the screw on that we took off in the back. Thank you. going to plug it back in. Okay, cool. So the printer just turned right back on once I plugged it in. It's probably going to give me an error. Yeah, there it goes. So just press start and then it'll ask you to print a nozzle check, and that's what we're going to do. So I'm just gonna make sure I still have clear lines. Everything is good. It's still printing correctly. And then I'll start printing on DTF film. Cool. All right, cool. So here's the nozzle check. It does look like cyan's missing one of the lines at the bottom. So I'll run a cleaning real quick and then start printing on DTF film. Stay tuned for the third part. I'm going to be setting up Accurate.